The Disneyland Walt Disney World Entertainment Division presents this character training tape so that you who are portraying the characters of Alice in Wonderland, the White Rabbit, or the Walrus will better understand the problems you might encounter. It's also our purpose to acquaint you with the personality of the character and the possibilities for animation and movement within the limits of the costume. Of course, the best way to get to know Alice in Wonderland, the White Rabbit, and the Walrus is to see them in their natural surroundings.
My, what a peculiar place to have a party. You know, Dinah, we really shouldn't be doing this. After all, we haven't been invited. And curiosity often leads to trouble.
Alice, that spunky, talkative little girl, is extremely curious. Very stubborn and just a bit sassy, young Alice is constantly chasing after the White Rabbit. Only when she loses him will she stop hurrying for a moment, set her fisted hands firmly on her waist, and replace her saucy grin with a confused pout. Indeed, Alice's curiosity has led her into Wonderland, the home of the Mad Hatter, the Queen of Hearts, the ridiculous Tweedledee and Tweedledum, and the sarcastic Cheshire Cat. It's no wonder that Alice wants to catch up to the White Rabbit and find out how to get home again. This White Rabbit is a fidgety, high-strung, eccentric rabbit who rarely stays still for more than an instant. He's terribly late for an appointment with the Queen of Hearts and hardly has time to say goodbye or hello, much less time to stop and chat. Like Alice, White Rabbit scurries from one point to another in a confused, hysterical pattern, always trying to make up for lost time. The Walrus is a fat, elderly moocher who's constantly in search of a free meal. His tricky little hands are always moving, whether it be straightening his tie, stroking his large mustache, or just wiggling his fingers. The Walrus is a well-dressed character, but is extremely lazy and enjoys stirring up trouble by teasing and mimicking those around him. He's harmless enough, but always seems to be up to no good. One is never quite sure what the Walrus is thinking. Whether you're playing a Disney character in the park, at a special event, in a department store, or out on the road, you should try to locate a clean, fairly spacious area in which to dress. Be sure to set your costume on a chair or table, or hang it up. As you go out to greet your audience, remember that the voices of the rabbit and the walrus are easily recognized, and the children are not fooled by imitation. So, with the exception of Alice, while you're in costume, you must not talk. Most importantly, always keep the safety of the children in mind. If you find yourself in a store situation, it's wise to move through larger aisles and stop in cleared areas so the children may surround you with a minimum of pushing and crowding. It's best to avoid smaller aisles, particularly those areas where fragile or breakable items are on display. Both the rabbit and walrus heads will impair your vision, and a quick turn or slip could cause an accident. It's also wise to leave objects of value alone. Cameras, purses, and shopping bags are easily dropped and broken. Should there be a mishap, leave the area and inform your supervisor immediately. Remember, you're working with a very young, unpredictable audience. Children are sometimes hard to understand and may give you an extra affectionate pat on the back or even a playful punch. Patience is the key word in being a Disney character. Most important to remember is that to the children, these characters are real. The fact that there is a person in the costume should never be revealed. Even though the costumes are limiting in some respects, try to move as naturally as possible. The Walrus, the White Rabbit, and Alice are full of energy and love to dance and perform.
A very merry and birthday to you, to you. A very merry and birthday to you, to you. It's great to drink to someone, and I guess that you will do. A very merry and birthday to you. Statistics prove that you've one birthday every year.
But there are 364 on birthdays. That is why we're gathered here to cheer.
A very merry and birthday to us, a very merry and birthday to us, if there are no objections, let it be unanimous. A very merry and birthday to us. A very merry and birthday to me.
Statistics prove that you've one birthday every year.
But there are 364 on birthdays.
Precisely why we're gathered here to cheer. A very merry and birthday to all, a very merry and birthday to all. Let's have a celebration, hire a band and rent a hall. A very merry and birthday.
A very merry and birthday.
A very merry and birthday to all.
Basically, your goal as a Disney character is to become that character. It's your job to bring the White Rabbit, the Walrus, and Alice in Wonderland to life. To give them energy, feeling, and color. Couple your imagination with your good judgment and always keep the safety of the children in mind. Remember, when you're in costume, the reputations of Alice in Wonderland, the Walrus, and the White Rabbit depend on you.
That's a wonderful character.